All right, guys, and moving forward in our CLT math practice test number one, I'm going to go through pretty quickly now and just pick questions that that we can pick up fast. So number 103 is one of those questions that you can do quickly. It's asking which of the following lines is parallel to the line x equals y. So parallel lines, what you got to know here is that parallel lines have the same slope. And what is our slope of the line x equals y? That's like y equals x, right? Either way you can say it. And that's y equals mx plus b, and m is our slope. And what is the invisible number in front of that x? Our slope is just 1. And looking over at our answer choices, only one of them has a slope of 1. So that's our parallel line. Number 104 is a question that it's got a few steps in here to solve. So I don't want to spend a whole lot of time here. If the perimeter of triangle CGD is 12 centimeters, so CGD, so the perimeter around the edges here is 12, and each half of the big triangle is congruent to each other. And it says DF is 5, so over here is 5, which means that's 5 because it's across from the 90-degree angle. What is the area of the big triangle? So we need to find out these two sides here, and we only have one side. So you've got to work the Pythagorean theorem, but instead of finding just one side, we got to find two sides. So I'm going to call this little bottom piece x, and I'm going to call this this height here of our triangle, this or this leg of this triangle over here, I'm going to call this 7 minus x, right? Because this dg plus this cg, they got to add up to 7. So if this is x, this over here is 7 minus x. So our Pythagorean theorem says that a squared plus b squared equals c squared, where c is the hypotenuse. So that's c is 5 squared. And we'll just call a this x squared, and b is a 7 minus x squared. And now when you go through and you multiply your binomials, you wind up with x squared plus x squared. Minus 14x plus 49 equals 5 squared. And when you go through and simplify that, it turns into 2x squared minus 14x plus 24 equals 0. And you can factor out a 2. X squared minus 7x plus 12 equals 0. And now we need to finish factoring. We got x minus something and x minus something. I know it's a minus something and minus something because the back is positive and the middle is negative. So what two numbers add to give us negative 7 and multiply to give us positive 12? That's going to be 3 and 4. So our sides over here, right? If x is 3 down at the bottom and the perimeter is 12, 5, 6, 7, 8, then over here, 7 minus 3, this side, the height, is 4. And if this half of my base is 3, then all the way across my base of the triangle is going to be 6. And you've got your formula for area of a triangle on your reference sheet. It is 1/2 base, base times height. So that's 1/2 of 6 times the height is 4. 6 times 4 is 24. Half of 24 is 12. So that's our area of our big triangle there. Excuse me. Number 105. I really like these because I like drawing angles. Let's see here. Angle 1 and angle 2 are supplementary angles. So that's two angles that add up to a straight line, that add up to 180 degrees. And then it says angle 2 and angle 3 are complementary angles. So the complementary has to add up to 90. Supplementary add to 180. So I'm going to go in with another color here. I got a 90 degree angle here now. So these two are angle 2 and angle 3. So this will be angle 2 and angle 3. And that angle 1, right, was supplementary with 2. So that goes all the way through here. And now it says, given that angle 3 and 4 are vertical angles, so that's angle 3, and it's vertical to 4, and angle 4 is 40 degrees, what's the measure of angle 1? Well, if angle 4 is 40, then angle 3 is 40 degrees. And 4 and 2 are complementary. They add up to 90. So if this is 40, then angle 2 over here is 50. 40 plus 50 makes 90. And the question is, what is the measure of angle 1? Well, that's 90 here plus 40 here is 130 degrees. Or you could say it's 180 degrees, a straight line minus 50. And that'll also give you 130 degrees.